Some recent studies have found a connection between the excessive intake of energy drinks and sudden cardiac death among young athletes. We asked cardiologist Dr. Ramin Mashadi to explain these findings.
Sudden cardiac death is a non-violent, non-traumatic, sudden collapse secondary to cardiovascular event.
Dr. Manshadi wants to make the public aware of the potential dangers in excessive intake of energy drinks.
Shock delivered.
We have to be quite aware and understand and be educated and know what the content of these energy drinks are. In essence, these energy drinks are not FDA approved. For that reason, they're considered dietary supplements. And because of that, there are no labelings on these drinks. So we don't know exactly the content of caffeine or taurine or ginseng or other things that are in there. The main factor is caffeine. And the reason behind it is that if you would drink a 12 ounce of soda, the content of the caffeine is only 35 milligrams. If you drink an energy drink, then the content is quite variable. It can be anywhere between 50 to 500 milligrams. So 10-fold increase in the amount of caffeine. So these young people, especially college students or younger, or even sometimes older people that want to do more and more with our busy lives, consume too much of these, and they drink to keep active or think to get the edge, to stay awake longer. And the caffeine is the main factor that can stimulate the heart and propagate and trigger arrhythmias. And these arrhythmias can lead to collapse and sudden cardiac death.
Dr. Manshadi tells us how caffeine affects us.
Caffeine use or abuse can lead to significant palpitations. These are some warning signs. So if you're having excessive palpitations when you consume these, then you're quite sensitive to caffeine, or whatever that you drank had excessive amount of caffeine. If you basically you feel your heart pounding really hard, or you feel lightheaded or very irritated, these are some of the effects of caffeine overdose. And in a young child, which is small in as far as size, excess amount of toxic amount of caffeine can lead to stroke and seizures. So what caffeine does, it's a stimulant. It basically bombards the heart to beat really hard. It's like adrenergic drive. And at the same time, it's a vasoconstrictor, meaning that it constricts the arteries. So when the arteries constrict, it basically propagates ischemia, which basically means you do not get enough oxygen to the muscle of the heart. If you do not get enough oxygen to the muscle of the heart, the muscle basically stuns, and it can propagate arrhythmias, and the person can collapse and subsequently die. It is noted that caffeine is also a diuretic, so it basically dehydrates the athletes. So you're running around, you're losing a lot of water, you're sweating hard, you're also taking these caffeine-loaded energy drinks that can even enhance diuresis, and it can lead to dehydration and collapse and other arrhythmias just because of that alone. I absolutely think that young children and young adults should not take these because their receptors are not ready for this amount of caffeine, and it can lead to other issues and problems. There has been a study for example, college students. Those that consume only 6 of these per month, they end up having a more addictive behavior. They're more prone of having drug addiction, alcohol addiction, and so forth. Young children, if they take these, they will have problem with insomnia, not able to sleep, irritability, and one would think that they may have ADHD and so forth. On top of that, they do contain some amount of sugar, which can also, studies have shown that the children that use this more often than others, they end up having more of advanced tooth decay, for example. So in general, for athletes, for young sporting athletes, the best fluid replenishment is water. Even Gatorade, if you're not exercising more than 1 hour in a humid place, you do not need Gatorade. Water is the best replenishment that's needed for the body when we do exercises. I strongly feel that there should be some regulation where there would be exact labeling of the exact content of these caffeine within these drinks. So we know exactly how much we're taking and what the subsequent negative effects that may happen if you take too much.